الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي عن الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونصلي ونسلم على محمد ابن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم القيامة إخوة الإيمان أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فتقواه سبحانه وتعالى من وصيته لنا وللأمم السابقة قال تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم واتقوه تفلحوا أما بعد في هذه اللحظات المباركات ونحن وإياكم قد اجتمعنا في بيت من بيوت الله لنؤدي صلاة الجمعة فنسأل الله أن يتقبلها منا بقبول حسن فأود أن نذكرنا بأهمية هذا الموضع هذا المكان هذا المكان يسمى مسجد موضع للسجود وأقرب ما يكون العبد إلى الله صلى الله إلى الله عز وجل كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم هو عندما يكون في السجود فاسم المكان للسجود هو المسجد والمسجد بيت من بيوت الله عز وجل قال تعالى وأن المساجد لله فالمسجد والمساجد كلها لله عز وجل وأول ما قام به وأول عمل قام به محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بعد الهجرة هو بناء مسجد فلم يهتم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ببناء قصر للدنيا بل اعتنى ببناء موضع يجتمع فيه المسلمون ليؤدي صلوات المفروضة ولتربية أولادهم ولتعليم كجامعة ككل شيء في الدين. My brothers and my sisters in the deen, we say Alhamdulillah always. Many thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, always for making us Muslims, for bringing us to Al-Islam. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّكَ لَن تَحْدِيَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. So the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not have the power or the influence or the control to bring to the deen whosoever he likes. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says to him, إِنَّكَ لَن تَحْدِيَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You will never be able to guide and to bring to this religion, to this deen, whosoever you like. ولكن الله but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يهدي من يشاء. He guides whoever he wills. So there is no guidance, akhi. There is no guidance, sisters, ukhti. That's better than Islam. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, there's no other religion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except Al-Islam. والإسلام الإسلام هو الاستسلام التام. It is the complete and total and unrelenting and impartial submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the word will is sometimes misunderstood by people. When we say to the will of Allah, it means anything that happens to us, we say is done by Allah. So even by definition of the Islam, some people become un-Islamic by default. Because once you start to question the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life, in your children's life, in your family life, in your business life, in your work life, then you are troubled. Because you haven't submitted, akhi. Impartial, uncompromising, relentless, because it's not seasonal, right? It's not because you can pick and choose. It's not because in the summer you can be a Muslim and in the winter you are not. Or you can be a Muslim in the winter because it's cold, it's dark, and in the summer it's bubbly, you're not a Muslim. You can be a Muslim in other months, but when it's Ramadan, you're not a Muslim. No. Al-Islam at-tam lillah, complete and unrelenting, unflinching submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is a guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he says to the Muhammad, he said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will never, lita'bid, never be able to bring to this deen the people that you want, the people that you like. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tried to guide some people. Allah did not want them to be Muslims. So they never become Muslims. They never died in Islam. So today, because of the very short time that we have for the khutbah, we want to remind ourselves of this place, this place. So we say, هذا المكان, this place, اسمه is called المسجد, the masjid, not mosque, it's called masjid. Masjid means اسمه مكان للسجود, where we prostrate, where we put our forehead on the floor for the sake and for the fairness and for submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now when a man stands erect, like I'm standing now, I'm facing you with my face, and my forehead is one of the most prominent part of my body. But I and you are not closer to Allah when we stand. Right? We are not closer to Allah when we stand up. But the Rasulullah said, "Akrab ma yakun al-abd ilallah," the closest that a slave and a servant can be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is when this forehead is on the floor for his sake. And therefore, this place becomes masjid. And the one place of worship is masjid. And if there are many, it's not masjids, it's masajid. Because we have this new system that the brothers are doing, akhi and akhis. No, we don't have that. You're an akhi, you're one, and you're ikhwa if you're many. We don't have akhis in the deen. So, this masjid, Bayt min Buyutillah, is one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And somebody will say, why do Allah need a house? Well, this house is not for Allah, but it is because it is the place where we come. Or where we should come. Or where we must come. On a regular basis. To congregate. To come as a collective. And pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do we pray? Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Not according to any philosophical standing or opinion or any philosopher's thinking. We pray kama qala Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sallu, pray kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as you see me pray. So when we make takbiratul ihram, we make the qira'ah, we make the ruku', we make the sujood, who are we following? We're following Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Where did Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam get it from? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it could have been very impossible for a man born in the desert over 1400 years ago to formulate for himself this way of praying. And for 40 or more years in his life, he's never lied. So if he doesn't lie to human beings, why can he come and tell us that he got it from Allah? Is it not, is that not graver or bigger? So that's what we believe. That's what we believe. And I tell some of my friends in other religions, I say to them, you see, the thing about us Muslims is we can connect everything that we do to a role model. So how do you do that? I say, well, it's in the Quran, it's in the Sunnah. If I'm drinking water, I can drink water according to how Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam drank water 1400 years ago. It's written. When we do a nikah, we do it like that. But if you go to some religious and some philosophies, it is based on other people's thinking. So that's the beauty of the deen. But some of us are not good salesmen for the deen. We coy, we shy, we want to go backward. What are you going backward for? But if you don't drink alcohol, you have to be ashamed of that. I said to my GP, to everybody, I don't drink. I don't need to drink. So that's why you're healthy. Well, alhamdulillah, you can be healthy too if you follow the same route. So coming to what we're saying, this is masjid. So the masjid is the place of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, "Wa anna al-masajid lillah," and these masjids are meant to be for the sake of Allah. Then, in the Sunnah, bringing you to the role model, when the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated عندما هاجر من مكة إلى مدينة when he migrated from Mecca to Medina أول عمل قام به the first work that he done بناء المسجد بناء مسجد is to build a mosque لم يبني قصر he didn't build a castle للدنيا for the world مسجد He built a very humble masjid. Atakana nafsuhu yusharik fi bina al-masjid. Even himself, he participated in building the masjid. Liyakuna markazan, so that it will be a center. And that's why the masjid in Medina is one of the centers. Now that's the sunnah. Why would the Rasul not build a house? Why would he not build a castle? Now in the terminologies that people have now, they call it strategic. Strategic means long term. And that's what should be our focus as Muslims. We live in now, but what is our strategic plan for the Akhirah? So the Rasul encouraged the Sahaba, everybody, to participate in building the masjid. Now he said in the hadith, Man bana lillahi masjidan, whosoever builds a masjid for the sake of Allah, Man bana li la. Because some people here, they still don't understand the terminology, they still don't understand Arabic, and they want to make as if they understand. When you say to them, how are you? Alhamdulillah. No, it's not Alhamdulillah, it's Alhamdulillah. All praise belongs to Allah. Or all praise is for Allah. So it's not Alhamdulillah, it's Alhamdulillah. So man bana lillahi. Whosoever builds a masjid for Allah's sake. Li for lillahi, Allah's sake. So you're not building it for political reasons. You're not building it to be seen of men. You're not building it because you want a status or status. No. Lillah. So it comes from the heart. Bana Allahu lahu baytan fil jannah. Then Allah will build for that person a house in Al-Jannah. Some riwayah says Allah will build them a castle in Al-Jannah. So the masjid is a very important place in the life of every believer. Now we see that in the hadith that comes after this. Ataibu min adhambin kamal adhamba law kana qad istaghfaru rabbakum law kana qad. Okay, alhamdulillah wa kafa wa so many thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those of our brothers and our sisters who are joining us, we have been talking about firstly the beauty of the deen. We said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides to the deen whosoever he wants, and he hasn't given that power and that influence and the control to even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّكَ لَن تَهْدِيَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنُ اللَّهِ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. So the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will never be able to guide whoever he wants, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides whoever he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. And we explained that Islam is the total, unrelentless, impartial, complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we explained that this place is called the masjid. A masjid comes from the place where we do our sujood. And sujood is when you prostrate your forehead on the floor. And being in sujood makes you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the closest a servant can be to Allah is when they prostrate. So the place where we prostrate frequently is the masjid. And this masjid, Baytun min Buyutillah, is one of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the masjid is the first, looking at role model, the first project that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started and finished started and completed when he migrated from Makkah to Medina. Now, the Rasul says, سَبْعَةٌ يُذِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ تَعْتَ ذِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ذِلَّ إِلَّا ذِلُّهُ. Seven categories of people will be placed under Allah Ta'ala's shadow, His canopy, His protection, His shade from the sun, from the hot burning sun, Yawm al-Qiyamah, in the day of Qiyamah. And amongst them is Qalbun, is Rajulun, a man, Qalbuhu mu'allakun bil masajid. Man whose heart is attached to the masjid. So by virtue of your heart being attached to the masjid, you'll be counted as one of the believers. And not only that, you will gain Allah's protection, Yawm al-Qiyamah, from the hot burning sun, on the day when there will be no shade to cover us. So these are just few things to show you how important the masjid is. So the masjid is important more than our beds, more than our homes, more than our houses, right? But what do we need to do to upkeep our masjid? Some of us, we only think of this masjid when we want to come to pray. But in our homes, we got a weekly budget. We're going to buy this. Every week we make a list, shopping list. But there's never an item on your shopping list that you say, this is for the masjid. Most of us. I know brothers here, they're doing a lot in this masjid. I know sisters here, they're doing a lot for this masjid. Some of them I don't know, but some I know. Take for example, our Sheikh and our Imam Sheikh Buhadi, Sheikh Abdul Salam. These people, most of the time when they are coming to this masjid, they'll bring a milk or they'll bring toilet tissue or they'll bring kitchen towels. Most of the time, anytime they come in here, and the brothers like Sheikh Shuaib and the brothers who come on Sunday, they also bring stuff. When it's Mondays and Thursdays, we have our mothers and our sisters, they cook, they bring food to the masjid. So make the masjid lively. But the majority of us, we don't contribute, we don't give anything. But even when we come, there are people who sacrifice, they come here on Thursday evening, Thursday night, to clean the masjid for us before we come on Friday. Some of the brothers, they come Friday morning, they hoover all this place, make it clean and nice. And if you remember, there was an old lady in the time of the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and he was a black lady as well. He was old and he was black. He was elderly and he was black, and he passed away. And she used to clean the masjid of the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And when she passed away, the Sahabas buried her. The Rasul did not know. But being the leader that he was, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that each and every one of us should be. You don't have to be a queen with the title or a king with the title. You are a responsible person in your own right. You are a leader in your own right. Nobody has to give you the accolade. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it to you. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that. Kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'ulun an ra'iyatihi. Each and every one of you is a shepherd. So you are a leader. A shepherd leads. So when the woman passed away and a few days the Rasul did not see her, he asked the Sahabas, where is the elderly lady? Where is she? I'm not seeing her. They said, oh, Ya Rasulullah, she passed away. And we buried her. He said, Subhanallah. You didn't tell me? You should have told me. See, even the way he spoke to his sahaba was with mannerism, was with respect, was with dignity. You should have told me. He didn't shout. And then he said, "Duluni ila qabriha." Take me to her grave. And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed for her. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? Inna salataka sakanun lahum. When the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam pray for you, it is peace, it is tranquility. Right? So even though the elderly lady was buried by the Sahaba because oversight, they might have thought, oh, we don't need to bother the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam with this, she just passed away, we can do this. I'm not standing here to judge. And I don't want you even to think about that. Because this is what brought problems in people's life in the deen. They start judging the Sahaba. You're judging the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam Sahaba? You don't have that power. So I'm not standing here to judge. I'm just saying to you, the woman gained the dua of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam on her grave, even though she passed away and she was buried without the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam's knowledge. Why? Because she used to clean the masjid. So my brothers, the khutbah is coming to an end. We have overheads in the masjid. The masjid is not run like that. We have bills to pay. There are people who come here, like I said, to break their fast. Some people bring milk. They buy milk for the masjid. Yeah, this is sadaqa jariyah. Like we said, it's strategic. Anything you spend for the sake of Allah towards your qiyamah is better than what you spend for this dunya. And the end of Surah Al-Munafiqun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. Spend what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for you. Sometimes it's not physical money. Sometimes it's just an advice. Sometimes it's just come in yourself and say, today I want to clean the masjid. Do that min qabli an ya'tiya ahadakumul maut, before death comes to one of you. Fayaqula, and you will say, Rabbi lawla akhartani ila ajalin qareeb. Oh Allah, if you delayed me for a very short while, then I will give charity. I will be amongst the good ones. Then, with learn, like we said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, learn, you will never be able to guide the person that you want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the same article here. He said, learn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never add a single time to your time when it's over. وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Learn. So we are running a race against time. And I tell you, my brothers and my sisters, don't look at the next person. Look at yourself. You don't know whether your time is finishing. And you do not have the power to share the lifespan. It's shared by Allah anyway. You don't have the power to share the risk, the provision. It's shared by Allah. You don't have the power to share the position. Allah, that's Allah's job. That's Allah's work. But when it comes to fighting and striving and competing for Yawm al-Qiyamah, we are all on a level playing field. So, this is not Sheikh Buhari's masjid. It's not Sheikh Abdul Salam's masjid. It's not Sheikh Shuaib's masjid. It's not Sheikh Abdullah's masjid. It's not mine. It's none of us masjid. It's masjid for Allah. So do it for the sake of Allah. You can set a direct debit. When you come into the masjid, don't bring £1. Coins. Yaki, this is a bank for you. It's an account that you have, Allah SWT has opened for you. And if you do it with sincerity, your reward is with Allah SWT. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to to bless and to guide us.
Amen.
We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أقم الصلاة فإن الصلاة كانت على المتقين. To give us the courage to spend for His sake. All our people who have passed away in the time.